My life has been a tapestry of rich and royal hue, an everlasting vision of the ever-changing view, a wondrous woven magic in bits of blue and gold, a tapestry to feel and see, impossible to hold. Once amid the soft silver sadness in the sky, there came a man of fortune, a drifter passing by. He wore a torn and tattered cloth around his leathered hide, and a coat of many colors, yellow, green on either side. He moved with some uncertainty, as if he didn't know just what he was there for, or where he ought to go. Once he reached for something golden hanging from a tree, and his hand came down empty. Soon within my tapestry along the rutted road, he sat down on a river rock and turned into a toad. It seemed that he had fallen into someone's wicked spell, and I wept to see him suffer, though I didn't know him well. As I watched in sorrow, there suddenly appeared a figure gray and ghostly beneath the flowing beard. In times of deepest darkness, I've seen him dressed in black. Now my tapestry's unraveling, he's come to take me back. He's come to take me back.
You're welcome. Today we join people all over the world as we come to remember those who have died and those who are suffering through HIV/AIDS. Today we also remember those who are working to stop the AIDS pandemic, those who are caregivers, and those who mourn, and those who are working to end stigma and discrimination. According to UNAIDS estimates, there were up to 42.5 million adults and 2.2 million children living with HIV at the end of 2019. And during the year, 2.2 million new people became infected with the virus. Around half of all the people who do become infected with HIV do so before they are 25 years of age. 95% of the total number of people with HIV/AIDS live in the developing world. Now, thankfully, new HIV infections have reduced by 40% since the peak in 1998, but HIV still remains a threat to people of all ages and nationalities. The forgotten pandemic. This is the theme of this World AIDS Day 2020. The forgotten pandemic is an appeal to us all to encourage governments and policymakers to ensure that they meet the targets that they have agreed to in the fight against HIV and AIDS. Some of the most important of these promises are contained in the UN GAS Declaration and the 3x5 initiative. The UN GAS Declaration of Commitment was signed by all 189 members of the UN in June 2001, and the governments of the countries committed themselves to taking action on HIV/AIDS in the fields of leadership, prevention, care and support, treatment, reducing vulnerability and human rights. This included an increase in the annual spending on HIV and AIDS to 47 to 100 billion in low and middle income countries, and those countries experiencing or at risk of experiencing rapid expansion of HIV epidemics. Now, in the light of the recent proposal to cut overseas aid, this undertaking is at risk. People are at risk. This is a risk of a forgotten pandemic spreading once again, and rather than saving money now to look after our own, we should be looking after our neighbour, ourselves. We are in the midst of a pandemic, and we should know only too well the hidden dangers that could await anyone.
The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And also with you.
May the God who calls us to unity and the fullness of life and love unite you all.
Amen.
The red ribbon is an international symbol of AIDS awareness, a symbol of respect for HIV-positive people and people living with AIDS. And it reminds us all of the constant need to keep up with the fight against AIDS. It was created in early 1991 by Visual AIDS in New York for a global symbol in the fight against AIDS. A symbol for solidarity and tolerance with those often discriminated by the public, the people living with HIV and AIDS. In the style of the yellow ribbons, which were popular in the USA at the time as a symbol for awareness of the soldiers fighting in the Gulf War, the red ribbon was born. The red ribbon is red, like love, as a symbol of passion and tolerance towards those affected. Red like blood, representing the pain caused by the many people that died of AIDS. Red like the anger about the helplessness by which we are facing a disease for which there is still no chance for a cure. Red as a sign of warning not to carelessly ignore one of the biggest problems of our time. Wearing the red ribbon is your first step in the fight against AIDS. Now is your opportunity in the future to wear a ribbon on World AIDS Day.
God, who comes alongside and lives within, we thank you for the privilege of being together at this time and in this place.
We thank you.
We pray that your love will unite us into a community of grace and discovery. Please cleanse from us anything that would sap our strength for togetherness. Free us from negative imaginations and the barriers that sometimes keep us apart. In this time, refresh in us the dream of a better world and put before us new possibilities for service.
Lord, hear us.
Renew in us your compassion, so that we may be a people with loving purposes. We come together to be your Alleluia in a troubled world.
Amen.
A reading from the Gospel of St. Mark. From there, Jesus set out and went away to the region of Tyre. He entered a house and did not want anyone to know he was there, yet he could not escape notice. But a woman whose little daughter had an unclean spirit immediately heard about him, and she came and bowed down at his feet. Now the woman was a Gentile of Syrophoenician origin. She begged him to cast the demon out of her daughter. He said to her, "Let the children be fed first, for it is not fair to take the children's food and throw it to the dogs." But she answered him, "Sir, even the dogs under the table eat the children's crumbs." Then he said to her, "For saying that, you may go. The demon has left your daughter." So she went home, found the child lying on the bed, and the demon gone.
I can say without a shadow of a doubt that 2020 has been a really unusual year. None of us expected when we started the year to spend most of it not with our friends, not with our neighbours, and not with most of our families. We didn't expect most of the year to spend it in lockdown, or a semi-sort of lockdown of one description or another. And now we hear that it's probably going to go on until at least February next year, so that'll make it 12 months. 12 months of a life that's very, very different. It's strange when life takes a sudden turn that you don't expect. And when that happens to some people, you rely on your friends, you rely on those who you're closest to. But what if those who you believe are your friends, those who you believe are the ones that you can rely on, are not your friends at all, because they turn their backs upon you? In the reading we heard from Mark's Gospel, we hear of a woman from Syrophoenicia. Now, it's important that we know that she's from Syrophoenicia, because she's a foreigner. She's not welcome in that land. She's an outcast. She's different to everybody else, and she's not welcome at all. And Jesus himself makes it very clear, because she comes to him for help, and she says, "My daughter needs help, and you are the person to help her." And his response is not what we would have expected. His response is not, "Oh, well, here you go, here's the healing that you expect." No, he said, "You don't take the food from the table and give it to the dogs." He called her a dog. How many people who live with HIV and AIDS are really thought of as dogs, as outcasts, as those who we really want nothing to do with? Over the years, over the 10, 20 years, 30 years, people still have that attitude. When this pandemic first began, people would barrier nurse, they would cover themselves in the same way as they began with this current pandemic. But somebody broke through that. Somebody who changed our perspectives on everything. Princess Diana. Princess Diana cut through the protocol, cut through everything, and went forward and held the hand of somebody who nobody else would go near. And that's what Jesus did exactly at that time as well. He pointed out the fact that everybody else was calling her a dog, and then gave her the healing that she asked for. And she went away happy. But are we sending people away happy? People are mourning their loss of a loved ones, and we should be reaching out with love to them. Each of us during this pandemic may know of relatives in our own lives who have suffered, relatives in our own lives who may well have died, relatives of others who have suffered as a result of what is going on. We know this only too well. You can carry on quite carefully, and then suddenly the rug is pulled out from under your feet and you don't know what's going to happen next. You can build a life that's going to be so perfect that you know is going to be the life of your dreams. You can meet a person that you love, and other people can turn around and say, that love is not correct, that love is not right. But love is love. And it doesn't matter what anybody says, you can't change what is. God is love, and those who live in love live in God, and God lives in them. And therefore, knowing that truth, it sets you free. But what if we sang our lives to a different tune? Instead of singing our lives quietly, we sang them out loud. What if we did it with a great big orchestra? What if our life, what if everything we dreamed of wasn't a quiet little song, but a great symphony? A symphony for the world to hear. And you've planned it all, but something goes wrong. That's what happens for those with HIV and AIDS. But we have an opportunity to put things right. We have an opportunity to help others, to lobby our politicians to make sure that aid is given to our neighbour, to help others, because we don't know when it's going to happen to us. It may not be HIV and AIDS. It may well be something else. But that something else brings the exact same pain and hurt and anguish that no one should need to suffer. So let us sing together. Let us play together our own symphony.
And now your song is a repeat, and I'm dancing on. be. And when you're gone, I feel incomplete. So if you want the truth, I just wanna be part of your symphony. Will you hold me tight and not let go? Symphony, like a love song on the radio. Will you hold me tight and not let go? I'm sorry if it's all too much, but every day you're here I'm healing. And I was running out of love. I never thought I'd find this feeling. Cause I've been hearing symphonies before all I heard was silence. A rhapsody for you and me. And every melody is timeless. And now your song is on repeat.
God, our Father, we thank you that you have made each one of us in your own image and have given us gifts and talents with which to serve you. We thank you for those whose lives we have shared and whom we remember this night. We thank you for the good we have experienced in them and for the blessing they have been to us. Give us faith to leave them in your care, confident in your promises. We live in much darkness. We are often uncertain. We are sometimes afraid. In the darkness, we light a candle of hope. We all have sorrows. We have known pain. Each of us carry special regrets. In our palm, we light a candle of forgiveness. We are sometimes lonely, and the world seems cold and hard. in our loneliness, we light a candle of love. We have known awe, wonder, mystery, and glimmerings of perfection in our imperfect world. In our wonder, we light a candle of praise. May our separate lights become one flame, that together we may be nourished by its glow. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen.
Rose and flows of angel hair, and ice cream castles in the air, and feather canyons everywhere. Looked at clouds that way, but now they only block the sun. They rain and they snow on everyone. So many things I would have done, but clouds got in my way. I've looked at clouds from both sides now, from up and down, and still somehow it's cloud illusions I recall. I really don't know clouds. Moons and Junes and Ferris wheels, the dizzy dancing way that you feel, as every fairy tale comes through. I've looked at love that way, but now it's just another show, and you leave them laughing when you go. And if you can, don't let them know. Don't give yourself away. I've looked at love from both sides now, from give and take, and still somehow it's love's illusions that I recall. I really don't know love. I really don't know love at all. And feeling proud, to say I love you right out loud. Dreams and schemes and circus crowds, I've looked at life that way. Oh, but now, old friends, they're acting strange, and they shake their heads and they tell me that I've changed. Well, something's lost, but something's gained in living every day. I look at life from both sides now, from win and lose, and still life's illusions. I recall, I really don't know life at all. Life's illusions that I recall, I really don't know life, I really don't know life at all.
God, our loving Creator, your Son Jesus chose to be vulnerable in order to understand and identify himself with us. We are wounded in many ways, and we implore you to heal us and make us healers with you to help heal our broken world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for the leaders of the nations and for all faith leaders. Give them courage and strength to take a lead in working to prevent the further spread of HIV and to care for those affected. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for young people in their vitality and idealism. Bless them with good friends to help them accept themselves in all their vulnerability and challenge them with high ideals. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for those who are sick and in pain, especially those affected by HIV and AIDS. May they experience your love through each one of us. May they find meaning and purpose in their lives and inspire others who suffer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for a halt to the spread of HIV and AIDS worldwide, but especially in areas of poverty and pandemic, where communities are decimated and drugs are out of reach. Lord, bring miraculous healing. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. We pray for all those who work for development and justice. May they not be discouraged as they struggle to create a healthier world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Lord, we thank you that you have made all of us in your own image and likeness. Help us to be sensitive to one another and to build healthy and caring communities in your world. We ask this through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
As we finish our service, we remember that death is not the end. We know that there is hope. During this current pandemic, we have seen the love which people have shared with one another. So let us take that love and share it far and wide. Encircle us, O God. Keep love within, hatred out. Encircle us, O God. Keep joy within, despair out. Encircle us, O God. Keep peace within, disharmony out. Encircle us, O God. Keep hopes within, discouragement out. Your presence is in us. Your presence is around us. Your presence is love. Your presence is in us. Your presence is around us. Your presence is joy. Your presence is in us. Your presence is around us. Your presence is peace. Your presence is in us. Your presence is around us. Your presence is hope. Encircle us, O God, and may we go out in peace. Amen. And so go forth into this broken and hurting world with the blessing of the Father, the healing authority of the Son, Jesus Christ, and the power and guidance of the Holy Spirit. Go forth and bring healing with you wherever you go. In the name of Christ. Amen.
God of the fragile hearts we are, I come to you. God of our history, God of the future that will be, what will you make of me? I come. God of the meek and mild, God of the reckless and the wild, God of the unreconciled, I come to you. God of our life and death, God of our secrets unconcealed, confessed, God of our every living breath, I come to you. God of the rich and poor, God of the princess and the whore, God of the ever open door, I come to you. God of the unborn child, God of the pure and undefiled, God of the outcast and reviled, I come to you. God of the war and peace, God of the junkie and the priest, God of the greatest and the least, I come to you. God of the refugee, God of the prisoner and the free, God of my doubt and certainty, I come. God of our joy and grief, God of the lawyer and the thief, God of our faith and unbelief, I come to you. God of the wounds we bear, God of the deepest dreams we share, God of our unspoken prayer, I come to you. God of a world that's lost, God of a lonely cross, God who has come to us, we come to you.